thought you were really gonna pick me up.
All right, here we go. Live Church Kids TV. Let's get the body up. Let's get the blood pumping. Get those muscles loosened up. Yep. Here we go. First thing we're gonna do, sassy fish, right?
Sassy fish. Everybody stand up. Put your hands on your hips. You're gonna wave in those hips. Yeah, wave in those hips. You gotta be really sassy about it. Get your face into it. Like, you don't care about anything. No. Oh, we're gonna go a different route this time. We're gonna go to the angry sumo. So here we go. We're gonna get one leg. Rah! Rah! No, pick me up, no, don't do that at home. Don't try to pick each other up. All right, the last thing we're gonna do is we're gonna sneak up and wake our parents up for church. Here we go. You're gonna say, whoa,
oh, you hear that loud. Yeah.
You're gonna get to the door and open it up. You're gonna walk over to the bed. You're gonna pull the covers back, and then you're gonna say, it's time to go, go. Ooh, hope your blood's pumping. Let's worship, guys.
Hey! the rain, this passion in my soul. I will dance, I will sing, to be mad for my king. Nothing, Lord, is in the rain, this passion in my soul. In the rain, there's passion in my soul. I will dance, I will sing, to be mad for my king. Nothing, Lord, is in the rain, there's passion in my soul. Now they call me even more undignified than this. Some may say it's foolishness, but I'm the king, even more undignified than this. Passion in my soul. I will dance, I will sing, to be mad for my king. Nothing, Lord, is in the rain. There's passion in my soul. And I'll become even more undignified than this. Some may say it's foolishness, but I'll become even more undignified than this. Leave my pride by my side. And I'll become even more undignified than this. Some may say it's
going on, Life Church kids. First, happy Mother's Day weekend. So I've got a really incredible message about the love of our mothers and the motherly figures in our life towards us. But before we do anything, what are we going to do? We're going to pray. Great job. So let's go ahead and bow our heads and close our eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for who you are. We thank you for being a God that is for us, a God that is with us, a God who will never leave nor forsake us. We love you, Father, and we thank you for the love that you show us. Father, we thank you for the moms and the motherly figures, our grandmas, our aunts, our teachers, everyone in our life who shows us that type of love that you want them to show. I pray that, Father, that our ears are open, our eyes are open, our hearts are open, receive what it is you want us to receive. And we ask this in your son's name. Amen. So we're going to talk about a really quick Bible story over the book of Ruth. Now, Ruth is found in the Old Testament. You can turn there if you want to. I'm actually just going to kind of recite what goes on and kind of make it a little bit shorter. So in the book of Ruth, we're introduced to this woman named Naomi. Everybody say Naomi. Now, Naomi, she goes on to marry this man named Elimelech, and they have two sons, and they're living in a little town called Bethlehem. Now, there's this famine that comes along, and this famine means that there's no rain, there's not enough food for everyone. So they've got to leave Bethlehem and go to this city called Moab. Now, in Moab, it's not some kind of nice, cuddly type of city. In Moab, what they do is they worship false gods. They do kill people thinking that it was okay because their gods told them it was okay. Now, not only does Naomi and Elimelech and their sons have to deal with that, but Naomi's husband passes away. He dies. We don't know why, but he's gone. So Naomi goes, okay, I've got to get my sons married because it's very important that they have wives of their own. So she goes out and finds these two women named Orpah and Ruth, and they marry her sons. And for the next couple years, they're a nice, happy little family. But something else happens to Naomi. Her sons, they both die.
So imagine that. Imagine Naomi, this woman, here she is loving God, and her husband passes away, and then both of her sons pass away. Now, Naomi finds out that in Bethlehem, where the famine was, that she is going to actually go back because the famine has been lifted and rain started coming back and there's enough food for everybody. So she starts going back, and her two daughters-in-law, who are no longer obligated to stay with her or help her at all, they start going with her a little bit of the way. But Naomi turns around and says, Orpah, Ruth, you don't need to come with me. Stay home in Moab. Go marry somebody else. Go have a nice family. You are no longer under any type of obligation to be with me. Now, Orpah, she cries a little bit and she goes off. We never hear about Orpah again in the Bible. But Ruth actually decides to continue to go with Naomi. And I'm actually going to read to you what it is Ruth says, because this shows us how much Naomi really, really loved Ruth. So this is in Ruth chapter 1, verses 16. And I said Nuth. I did not mean Nuth. I meant Ruth. So, but Ruth replied, "Don't urge me to leave you or turn back from you. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people, and your God, my God. Where you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, if even death separates you and me." Now, here's the thing. Ruth didn't worship the real God. She most likely worshiped some false god, if any god at all. But here comes Naomi into her life, and Naomi loves her so much that Ruth's heart begins to turn towards God, the God that created the heavens and earth, the God that created you and me. And Ruth loves Naomi so much because Naomi loved her. Ruth is willing to leave her family. She's willing to leave anything that's comfortable, willing to leave all of her friends to go with Naomi so Naomi doesn't have to be alone. Now, if you read on into chapters 2, 3, and 4, we see how Naomi continues to love Ruth because Naomi helps Ruth marry a man named Boaz. And the beautiful thing about this story is that it's kind of a pre-picture, if that's the right word. It's a picture of what Jesus does for us. You see, Boaz helped save Ruth from the terrible circumstances she was in, just like Jesus helped save us from the terrible circumstances we find ourselves in sin and death. But Ruth would have never been able to remarry or never gotten married first in the first place if it wasn't for Naomi. And the reason I tell you that is because I want you guys to know that your moms love you so much. Now, you may not know your birth mom, and I wish that you did, but if you don't, that's okay. Maybe you have a stepmom, a foster mom, an aunt, a grandma, a big sister, a teacher, a faith factory leader, someone at church who just loves you and takes care of you, and they pour all kinds of good words into your life. Those can be your motherly figures. Those can be your moms on this Mother's Day. Now, I want to tell you this. Just because your moms love you does not mean that you can just walk around and go, "Yay, my mom loves me. I don't have to do anything." No, you have a responsibility towards your moms. And I'm going to read this to you. Now, some of you might know this. This is found in Exodus 20. It's one of the 10 commandments. And this is what God tells us how we should treat our moms on Mother's Day and any day of the year. "Honor your father and your mother so that you may live long in the land the Lord your God is giving you." Honor your father and your mother. Not just obey them, honor. Everybody say the word honor. Yeah, you know what honor means? Honor means that you go one step above simply obeying. It means that, you know what, you think of what your mom's wanting you to do before she even asks you to do it. It means that you go and you clean your room when you're asked to clean it with a good attitude, and you do it the first time they ask. It means when your mom's not expecting it, you go up to her and say, "Hey, mom, thank you so much for everything that you've done for me." You see, the reason God wants us to honor our fathers and our mothers is because it helps teach us, if we honor them on earth, we're going to honor him in heaven. It helps show us how God's treating us, and he loves moms and dads, especially on Mother's Day. It's a day designed for us to show our love and appreciation back to them. So this is what I want you to do. I'm going to leave you with a challenge. I want you to do three things for me. The first thing, I want you to go find your mom or your grandma or whoever it is that's in your life that you believe is your mom, and I want you to tell them that you love them. Now, don't just run by them and go, "I love you," and go outside and play. Don't do that. Really tell them you love them. Second thing I want you to do is I want you to make your mom a present. Maybe you bought them something. Maybe you already made them something. That's great. Make them something else. Maybe you go out on the sidewalk and draw them a really cool picture. Maybe you write them a card. Maybe you go pick them a little bouquet of flowers. What that is showing is that you're willing to sacrifice for your mom because she's done so much for you. She takes you to ball practice. She takes you to school. She helps you go on field trips. She helps you with homework. She reads to you. She helps you if you're scared. All of that stuff. And by doing something for her, it's showing you that you appreciate her. The last thing I want you to do is I just want you to say a really quick prayer and thank God for the moms in your life. Just tell him thank you so much because he had a plan in place to put those women in your life. So I'm gonna pray over you guys. Go ahead and bow your heads and close your eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, again, we thank you, we love you, we praise you for who you are. Thank you for the motherly figures and the moms in our life. God, they are here for a reason, to help us grow, to help us learn, and to help us grow closer to you. Thank you, Father, so much for all that you're doing for us while we're here. We ask this in your son's beautiful name, amen. So guys, I want you to simply remember, love God, love people, and you are incredibly, incredibly awesome. I'll talk to you next time. See you later.